So we're living in this cabin, and I asked her if I could try to find her a babysitter. So at the crematorium, I asked one of the guys there if he knew anybody that could possibly help us with this situation. He said, yes, we have a son, and he's watched by this person and such and such. And so I said, well, give the phone number. So we were having a Sunday dinner, and went into a Pizza Hut. And I tried to phone this girl that is a babysitter. Sandy was in the van waiting in the parking lot. So she comes into the Pizza Hut, grabs the phone out of my hand, and says to the babysitter, I don't know why Barry doesn't want me to speak to you. This is someone that, you know, we had never met. I never spoke to before. And we got into an argument there, and she says, take me home right now. And I said, I'm not taking you home right now. I'm not going to. I didn't raise my voice. I just said it just like that. She said, if you don't take me home right now, I'm phoning the highway patrol, which are like a more elite, a more, you know, stronger form of a policeman in America. The highway patrol, it's like, you know, the people that deal with more serious problems. She said, I'm phoning the highway patrol. I said, go ahead and phone them. I'm not taking you home. I'm not going to move from here. You know, I just said it like that. And so she did. She phoned them. And when they got there, she went on and on about all of her favorites, from the Arab spy to Charlie Manson to everything she could think of. And they said, they ended up saying things like, well, ma'am, he hasn't done anything wrong. Can you just go home? Can you just go home? No, I'm not going home. And he has to give me the keys or else I won't go home. I want the keys. I said, I'm not going to give you the keys because I know you'll lock me out. They suggested that she go to the Women's Abuse Center as a last resort. This is all over, trying to get her a babysitter. So she said, all right, I'll go to the Women's Abuse Center. So she took off. She just got in the police car and left. So I went to work the next day, came home, and everything in the house that I owned, which were some quite expensive things, electronic things, quite a few musical instruments. One very, very good violin that was assessed at over 2,000 pounds. Many, many things like that, including my vehicle, was all smashed to bits. The engine of the vehicle was carburetor, and all the bits in there were hit with a hammer and smashed. Violin was broken to bits. Many things were smashed. All my clothes and bedding was put in a pile and thrown into through a big tip. The boy, from what I found out later, put bug poison all over my bed, all into the sheets and all and the mattress. Everything was in completely destroyed in the house when I got home. So what I did immediately, I rushed out. And I went to a place that was like Harrods in Miami and bought her a very nice dress. That's my first reaction. And then I bumped into her in a coming home from some grocery shop, and she didn't see me. I was trailing her. And then I found out this women's abuse center where she was staying. So here I was armed with a dress. In the bushes, peeking in through the window, trying to see if I could see where she was, because I was going to give her this as a present. And she was telling. I remember hearing her saying to this other person, another abused woman, and there she was saying, "I'm going to plant a gun and the old thing where she was going on about trying to get me put away for 5 years." She was saying that to him, just telling all these stories about how evil things I was. So I went around to the front door. This is after I heard this conversation. I knocked on the door, said, is Sandy in there? And I could see through the chain, because it was like chain along. I could see everybody rushing, going for battle stations. And I could see them also phoning the police. Sandy phoning, or somebody was phoning. The police came. I didn't move. I thought I was still going to want to just give her the dress. It was a very nice dress. And so the police, every once in a while you find police in Florida that are very, very bad, very, they make, you know, they're not doing their job at all. In fact, I've had situations where the police have stopped us, and while we were handcuffed, this is a completely different story though, they would burn frogs with their cigarette butts. Cigarettes. Burn, you know, frogs while they were waiting to have us taken away. Things like that. That's sort of the police that I ran across at this point. And they were making a big joke out of me standing there with a dress. You know, here we found this one with a dress, trying to try on a dress at this woman's abuse center. You know, things like that that were going on. It was a big laugh, you know, folks were laughing. Brought us into the police station. It was another big laugh there too. So shortly after that, when I got out of jail, I met Sandy again. And she said, look, take back the dress, get the money back for it, I need it for rent. So I did do that. I took it back, got the money for the rent, and got back together with her. It was like I almost didn't have any reaction whatsoever to any bad things she would do at this point. You know, did you notice that? There was, you know, all these things that I was supposed to get really upset with. I forgot to get upset completely.
It's a very nice dress. It was a very nice dress.